people. Oh, and that's the good one. That's the good one. Get on it, Mike.
I'm Monster Mike, and you're watching Kayak Bassin TV in Miami, Florida.
Hey guys, I just got my stuff unloaded to head down and pick up a buddy that I'll be fishing with while I'm here in Miami. He'll be joining me in just a second. Brought a lot of gear because when I go on these long road trips, you kind of never know what you're gonna need. You never know what conditions are gonna pop up, and sometimes when storms and things like that pop up, I have to audible and fish for something different or go somewhere different or whatever. So I always have to carry like way too much gear. And so now I am headed down to pick up my special guest for tomorrow's show on Kayak Bassin TV, but we're gonna do a little preemptive urban assault looking for some peacock bass, Mayan cichlids, honestly whatever we can get into here in Miami. And so I'll be right back with my special guest, Monster Mike. You guys can look him up on Instagram. I'll put a link to his Instagram page in the description box below, but it's at @monster_mike86. Actually, I'll just put it on the screen right here as well, or over here, or however I do it. Still trying to work all that out. But we are in Miami, Florida. We are in peacock bass country, and so it is hotter than donut grease down here in Florida right now, so the bite's gonna be tough midday unless we go super deep. But again, I'm gonna leave all that to Monster Mike because he's the pro, and I'm basically just gonna be the student along for the ride on this trip, see what I can figure out. Looking forward to the urban assault down here in Miami, Florida. Hope you guys enjoy it. All right, so let's go find Mike and get this thing started. Grab my keys. We are, so let me show you this sign, because when I thought it was Karate Hair Salon. So check that out. It's Karate Hair Salon, Live Bait and Tackle, Signs and Printing, and the China Me Restaurant and Wendy's Chocolate Factory. I thought when I got here, it was Karate's Hair Salon. And like, if you didn't like the way they cut your hair, they would just kick your ass. So anyway, let me walk in here and see if I can find Mike and go catch some peacocks. Let's go do this. So I thought the sign said Karate Hair Salon. And I was like, cause it's like together. So it looked like if you didn't like your haircut, they would just kick your ass. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, what's the name of the place here? Like, how do people find this?
F&F Bait and Tackle.
F&F Bait and Tackle. Y'all saw the number. So if you're down here doing this, this is where you come to gear up. Let's do a little quick flyby. So they got, I mean, they got what you need. Like, you hear that? You hear that aerator in the back? That's the bait. They got gulp. Can't go wrong with gulp. They got hooks. They got people going fishing. I mean, that's what you need with a tackle shop. I just never seen one with a hair shop, a barbershop inside of it. Is the barbershop inside of here?
Yeah, I just got my hair done.
We're gonna go do it. Say hey to everybody.
How you doing?
What's your name?
Darwin.
That's Darwin. So come holler at him when you come to Miami. All right, bro, you ready to do this?
Let's do this.
All right, let's do it.
All right.
Mike didn't have any faith in my ability to catch fish, so he got a bait bucket. All right, brother, let's do this.
Let's do it.
Where are we headed?
Go straight.
So guys, what we got going on here is I just got to town. We're filming with Mike for Kayak Bassin TV for the next 2.5-3 days. It's like 5:30, and so Mike and I are doing a meet and greet and eat and see who gets beat tonight for UFC 200.
It's gonna be fun.
Up at B-Dubs, and right now we're just gonna go, you know, the cameraman's late, his flight got canceled, we were gonna jump on the water this evening, and that's not gonna stop us. So I told him he needs to Uber it, cab it, shuttle it, thumb it, whatever he's gotta do to make it to the hotel, because Mike and I are going fishing.
Oh yeah.
Oh, my bad. I got this. All right, so we're going bombing in the neighborhood because we didn't bring the extra kayak.
Right here.
Man, and so, dude, let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
Are you jacked for the fights tonight?
Man, I'm totally pumped for the fights tonight. My good friend Amanda Nunes, she's gonna be like the main event. She's fighting Misha Tate. She was my training partner. I was the one that used to help her with her wrestling. Hope she wins, and man.
What weight class was that?
135.
Is that what weight class you were?
135. I was 125 when I used to fight.
I was 135 when I was like...
I told you I was a fighter?
Eight, yeah.
Okay, what we're doing here is basically we're taking a little bait hook, taking these shiners, going in through the bottom lip, out through the top lip, and letting them free swim. Look at that. Start, yeah. That is a gorgeous fish.
Beautiful peacock bass in Miami.
All right, guys, so we got on the water. We did a little ditch fishing right out of the gate. Mike hooks up with a monster peacock that was every bit of 7.5 inches. And then after that, hooked up with another one, probably 2.5.
Yeah.
Probably 2.5 pounds. If I was holding it, it would look like it's 1.5 pounds. When he's holding it, it'll definitely look 2.5. But so anyway, Mike was like, dude, we got to roll. I got another spot. So we jumped in the truck. We're doing a little bit of a urban assault.
Urban angling, yeah.
A little urban angling, urban assault here in Miami.
Yep.
Jumping from ditch to ditch, spot to spot, lake to lake.
Keep going.
And, yeah, we're just trying to get in a little bit of fishing before we go watch the fight tonight.
Got this. You got this, Amanda.
Misha Tate. Are you calling it? Misha Tate going down?
Misha what? Tate is
call
going.
The round.
Misha
call
Tate
the round.
Is going down.
Call the round.
It might go 3 rounds or it might go 2 rounds.
I'm saying two. Second round
knockout. Amanda got some powerful punches.
Dude, she's a beast. I used to train with her
out of MMA Masters.
She should have fought some scrubs and got a couple title defenses in. You would think she would have learned her lesson from Holly Holm.
Yeah.
She should have made a few checks.
Yeah.
Because now I think she's going to be drinking through a straw for a couple days. Sorry, Misha.
Yeah. I like this water. Look at that green.
Don't really see any.
Look at that green.
Is that a peacock?
Yeah, there's one right there, bro.
Is that one right?
Right here, to your right. Straight down. Oh no, that's a cichlid. That's a cichlid. Nice.
It kind of looks like a peacock down there, but it's not moving. And guess what? 100% peacock.
Let's throw a bait in there and get him.
Chilling right there.
Oh. I stuck my rod in here.
Alright, this one's all you. So get your rod.
Yeah, just
I'm gonna grab you a perfect size bait for this, you shitty.
All right, let's do it. I'll leave the whopper plopper in there until I get one on the board.
Yep.
We're going to bait hook this thing and do it up. All right, I'm going to run this real time, guys.
Okay.
Mike's finding the bait. We're going to hook it up, and then we're going to catch a fish. Real time.
Real time.
I'm just going to leave the camera rolling.
Yep.
I'm not going to edit it. You're not going to see the cross blur.
This is the real life action.
You're not going to see a cross blur, fade. Nothing, no editing, no fanciness, just called shot, peacock, urban angling, Miami, Florida.
There's a peacock bass under that rock right there.
Right, the second one out, right there?
This one.
So bring it back to it a little bit?
He's swimming down.
Oh, good. Yeah. Hopefully you guys can see this. I've got the polarizer on. I'm not sure how good it's going to show up.
Free line your line?
Yeah, it's free. I got a lot of slack laying on the water. So again, guys, one of the things I like to do is put my finger on the line, leave the bail open with a spinning rod. That way I can feel the bait get nervous. I can feel the fish take it, let it go so it can swim with it for a second.
He's backing up, so you're going to have to put it like right underneath that. Yep, exactly. He's there. Oh, there he is. He's coming. You're right. Wait. You're right.
Oh, got him. Oh, he took me.
Wait, okay, he'll do it again.
Oh,
there he went right back to
Yeah. Look at that bait taking off, saying hell with that.
He's like, fuck it.
Here we go. We're running this real time, guys.
Real time.
That was my fault. I had him. Put it in his face. He ate. Everything was perfect.
Be ready.
I just didn't do it right. It's my fault.
He sees it.
He ate it.
Oh, okay.
It was all me. I screwed that up.
Hold on. You're eight.
Oh, got him. Oh yeah. Get your butt up here. Let me put some drag on him.
Bring him over.
Yeah. Peacock. Look at that. He ate that joker. Mike's getting down there for the land. Booyah.
Peacock.
Oh, sorry, buddy. Oh, come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. I'm trying to get you going. Get you taken care of. Look at this. Oh, yeah. And you see when you mind your line, they don't get gut hooked. It's hooked right there in the top of the mouth. That is a pretty fish. I'm just going to go ahead and do the camera selfie. Look at that right there.
Want me to hold it?
Peacock bass.
Nice peacock. Yeah.
Boom. All right, ready? I'm going to just do a little quick promo. Hold the camera up. I'm Chad Hoover with Kayak Bassin TV. We're in Miami, Florida. Chasing the man in the flowered suit. So the sign right here says no fishing, swimming, diving, and lautering. So as long as you're not fishing, swimming, diving, and lautering, you can fish.
So
you
can just can't. So can I fish?
So we're going to see if we can get a fish right here. And then we're definitely not going to lauter. And we're definitely not going to swim. And we're definitely not going to do any of that other stuff. We're simply going to fish. We're not fishing, swimming, diving, and lautering. This is slick looking. Yep. Look at these green water, man. Look at this green water, man. Look at this perfect shelf right here. Look at this canopy and shade. See, this is the ticket for the kayaks tomorrow. This is going to help us beat the heat. Yeah. Get up in these canals. We're going to gear up tonight and fish tomorrow after we watch a lot of scraps tonight, UFC 200. And so, again, we're heading over there tonight for a meet and greet at the Buffalo Wild Wings. Hopefully some fans and some subscribers and some fight fans have come out and we can talk fighting, we can talk fishing. We can just talk, I mean, we can just hang out. We can have a couple wings, have a couple beers. Actually, who are we kidding? We're gonna have a few beers and we're gonna have a lot of wings.
A lot of wings.
And right now we're just fishing. Now, keep in mind, we are not loitering, swimming, and doing any of that other stuff simultaneously. We're not doing it. Oh, really?
I don't even know how to swim.
Mike doesn't know how to swim. Just, I didn't say that and buy into any particular stereotypes. Mike completely came out with that one on his own. I didn't say anything about, just so you guys don't comment below that I'm talking about chicken wings and swimming. That's all Mike. It got nothing to do with me. Anyway, here's the thing. We're gonna take this camera off so I can talk to y'all. We're at a point right now with the anger in this country that everybody just needs to chill out. Go fishing. Go fishing with people you don't know so you can get used to other people's stuff, man. The reason that we hate each other is because we don't know each other.
Yeah, man.
You can't hate somebody when you know them. It's so much harder to hate somebody and want to affect their outcome in life, want to affect their livelihood when you know them. So if you go out and embrace people, get to know them. Say hey to a cop.
Yeah.
Say hey to somebody that's not of your color. If you're black, say something to somebody yellow, white, purple, or red. If you're white, say something to somebody from every other color. If you're yellow, say something to everybody that, I don't even know what the colors are. Who cares? And especially in the fishing community, because we're all fishermen first and all that other bullshit second. So let's have a good time. Let's go fishing. Let's do a little bit of uniting. And here's the thing. When the haters show up, y'all do me a favor like you always do on this channel and hug a hater.
Hug him.
Hug a hater. Just throw some. Hug him. Just hug a hater. We were not fishing, swimming, diving, and lautering. We were only fishing, okay?
Yep.
We were not fishing, swimming, diving, and lautering. Oh, this spot looks awesome,
look,
dude.
There's a monster that lives, he's like 6-7 pounds. No. And I saw him like two days ago.
Let's get him. Let's do it.
Let's do this.
This is a sweet looking spot. I think I'm gonna do the live bait thing this time, Mike.
Do the live bait.
Let's get some results, baby.
Yep, just take your
let's get some results. Results. Where'd I put my rod? Oh, here we go. Shiners. You said there's a big one that lives over there on that side, huh?
Yeah. If you can.
He said if I could cast that far.
There's a boat coming. That's not good.
Well, we can get over there first. That'd have to be a total D-bag to throw. You said right by that bank?
Yeah.
Let's try to double up. Let's just go and call it a double up. I mean, let's just double up. Double up 4-pounders or better. We'll just call it that. You just go ahead and get the 7. I'll get a 4.
This bait, I can easily put it to where I saw it.
Right.
But it's the grass.
Yeah, just let it swim straight down. I'll come over here where you saw that one and pitch out with this little bait and see if... Let me see if I can see it from a higher vantage point. There's so many goldfish and cichlids and crazy stuff here, it's unreal. Lost my bait.
It's just right around the corner.
Alright. So as you can see here, guys, we're just fishing these little pull-offs, little canal system. Tomorrow we're gonna do the exploring and the real thing with the kayaks. Look at that, he's even baiting my hook. Look at that. So he's gonna get like an assist on this fish if I catch it, because
he's underneath the weeds.
I see him. Ooh, drop the bait. Let me redo this. This is a little bit like pitching for bass. So I'm gonna basically put this bass right on, or this bait right on the edge of that grass and drag him off. Oh, there he goes. Oh, he's swimming straight to the bottom to try to hide.
Oh, there's something under there. Man,
like, oh, here we go.
Oh, you're on!
Oh, nice.
It wasn't the big one.
No, it wasn't the big one. But that's a peacock. Ooh, double. Oh, and that's the good one. That's the good one. Get on him, Mike. Put some heat on him, baby. Put them little arms to work.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. Look at that. Mike is bowed up. Get him, baby. Get him. Drop mine back in the water, and I'm going to go help Mike get this stick out of the way so we can land this fish.
Wait, I was going to go down, but there's a spider right here. Oh, he's out.
Sweet. Mike said I was going to go down, but there's a spider.
Should I risk flipping him?
Huh? Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah. Beautiful peacock.
Hurry, there's something that just hit right there. 100% peacock bass.
All right.
Here, let me get you a bait.
You know, I came here undergunned. I got this 7-foot medium light. I might need to switch it up to a...
No, you're good.
To something with a little more balls.
Just put it right there.
You put some heat on that last one, dude.
You saw that, right?
Yeah. Here we go. Ready?
Yep.
Oh, there he is.
Nice. That's awesome. That's a good one, too.
Yeah, it's a good one. Dude, look at this dude right here. Look at that.
Yeah.
Look at that. Let me come here. I'll just come on you. Or oh, your rod's out. Let me just come around so I can land him over here.
And you can get chunky guy.
Look at that guy right there. Oh, come on, buddy.
Get him from over the water.
Ow.
They fight harder than largemouth, that's for sure.
Yeah, look at that dude right there.
That's a chunky one.
That is a nice one, dude. Look at that.
You stuck him good.
Yeah, buddy. I didn't want to be in that hole where he was at. Look at that color, guys. Wow. Let's get this guy back in the water.
Do it.
Let's get another one. And he just takes off and swims back to his spot.
Good job, bro.
Bro.
Here.
So, all short jokes for Mike are fair game all week.
Oh, yeah.
And all fat jokes for Chad are fair game for all week. So, we called
I never thought I would be fishing with Santa Claus.
We called a truce. Oh, nice. We called a truce on it because, I mean, we're actually self-deprecating for y'all's benefit. So you guys can enjoy yourselves.
Yep.
So enjoy the jokes. We're going to keep them coming.
We're just having fun.
It makes fishing fun. How are you?
Hi.